McGough, Al Ackerman, Jerry Hodak, Larry Adderley, and Rob Kress, weeknights at 5:30, 6, and 11.
A walk down Woodward with some women of the night. The story tonight at 11.
The crazy wild and the rough and rude. The dean don't like their attitude. The animals fraternity. Well, it could mean the end of you and me. Baby, baby, there's a house.
You asked for an incredible new driving experience.
Supra. You got it.
The new Toyota Celica Supra. Incredible pleasure.
Supra. You got it.
Touch is best described as unexpected. Incredible power.
Supra.
Fuel injected 6, 5-speed overdrive, 4-wheel disc brakes. Count on it, because it's built by Toyota.
When you got it, you got it, Toyota.
When I clean the bathroom, you know what's important to me? Killing germs. That's why I use the cleaning team from Lysol. First, Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner. It's the only foam that's Lysol. Cleans and shines without scratching. Next, Lysol Toilet Bowl Cleaner. It cleans the whole bowl. Dirt, germs, and rust stains brush away. Its directional spout sends full-strength disinfection even under the rim. For a clean, fresh bathroom. The cleaning team from Lysol.
Down just a little lower, Bombshell.
I can't get any lower.
That's an interesting position.
Oh, boy, I've never been able to do this kind of stuff before.
Wow. When's it gonna be my turn?
Is this the way you like it, Otter?
It's perfect. Just perfect.
Me next, Otter.
You'll have to get in line, Flounder.
Otter's the last one, guys. I'm getting tired.
Oh. You know something? Photography 1A is a lot better than Foods of the World 202.
You bet your life.
You know, when this spread about women in education hits the paper, I bet we all get A's.
Even if I get an F, it'll still be worth it.
Yeah.
Hmm.
In my desk, pussycat.
Warmer's working late tonight, guys.
Just as I promised.
Oh, I can't believe it. My very own degree in philosophy.
Philosophy, pussycat. And you know you've earned it. You've worked hard these past 2 months. All those dinner parties, the drinks, the desserts.
No, sweetie. Hands off. Now that I've got this degree, there's no more of that.
But Pussycat, please.
Don't beg. You're a dean. You're above that.
No, I'm not. I'm below it. I'm way below it. I'm the lowest.
It's very dangerous, Warmy. Very dangerous.
I know. But it's the danger that drives me wild.
My, the dean is hungry tonight.
That's what 19 years of marriage does to a man. Come here. You're good for me, pussycat.
Oh, Warmy.
Oh,
is what you call lecturing at the orphanage.
Marion, this is not what you're thinking. Gloria is one of our prize orphans.
Who is this woman? I'm the wife of the man you're sitting on, you sneaky little tramp.
Sneaky little tramp? I'm a philosophist,
and I'm going to kill you!
Oh,
Marion!
Sapheads doing in that boardroom? Get out! What is the meaning of this perverted behavior?
Perverted? Let he who is without sin cast the first stone.
You shut up.
How long have you been in there?
Us?
What? Eat this.
Eat it.
What's that? Oh, my God, no. Have you guys been taking pictures?
Give me that. You're gonna pay for this and pay me.
Marion, for God's sakes, can't we talk this over like two sensible, rational, level-headed human adulterers? I mean, adults.
Don't worry, Dean. You still got us.
Nobody else does it. When did I ever get caught?
To have and to hold, to honor and obey, till death do us part, you slimy.
Hello, Marion.
Shut up.
Look, Marion, I know you're mad at me. But it looked the way it was because it appeared to look the way it looked.
It looked the way it looked because it was.
What are you doing?
What do you think I'm doing? I'm leaving.
But, Marion, it's past midnight.
Let me assure you, I will have no difficulty finding a place to sleep.
Marion, you wouldn't dare.
And tomorrow morning, I'm going to jump up bright and early and sue you for every penny you've got. And every cent you haven't already squeezed from the alumni fund, the federal education grants, and the non-profit food concessions.
You are going to leave me my parking kickbacks.
When this divorce is over, you're going to be handing out diplomas in your shorts.
Probably take the hair off my comb.
What hair, you toad?
Memo from Dean Vernon Wimmer. To the file. Dated the day before yesterday. This morning I received a phone call from a Gloria Bancroft, a person I've never heard of. She claims she phoned me because... Yes? Buster Niedermeyer. So, the trustees are already descending on me, huh? The jackals. Cinnamon.
Hello, Vernon.
I gather you've read this afternoon's edition of the Faber Daily Outlook.
Indeed, I have. Not a very pretty picture. Vernon, you and I have been friends for a very long time. It hurts me to say this, but you must not soil the honor of Faber College.
Are you saying...
Resign.
Vernon Wormer is no quitter.
Very well, then. You made your bed. You'll have to lie in it, if you will excuse the unfortunate choice of words. We'll meet again when the trustees review your case. Oh, hello, son.
Oh, good afternoon, father, sir.
How many times must I tell you not to salute me?
You wanted to see us, sir?
Have you read the Faber Daily Outlook?
I'm afraid not.
Me neither. I've been busy preparing a speech for my ROTC class. Starvation.
a cost-effective military weapon. I'd like you to hear it.
No.
The press. Those scandal-mongering, muckraking, left-of-center donkeys.
They've never liked me.
It's obviously those goons at Delta House, sir. They've gone shutterbug crazy. They used their perverted minds to dummy up this forgery and send it to the paper.
It wasn't the Deltas, it was my wife.
It was no forgery. I got caught with my motor running.
You mean this is...
me, groping Gloria Bancroft. And now the board of trustees of this barely credited institution is going to have a hearing to determine whether I'm suitable to remain as dean.
It's a damn shame, sir.
Dean Wormer, I...
Stop that.
Get a hold of yourself, Tug.
You are one of my idols. You, Audie Murphy, Erwin Rommel, the Desert Fox.
Well, I'm sorry I let you down, Neenemar. But what can I say? Now, listen, I want you to have a chat with your father. He's on the board of trustees.
Say this isn't happening. Please?
Of course it's happening, you sniveling twerp.
I can't take this.
I'll go talk to Dad right now.
I'll be right here. I've thrown it all away. And for what? A bimbo. With a body that just wouldn't quit.
One of the biggest new car announcements this year is not a car. It's the GM Continuous Protection Plan, a great new comprehensive continuous repair plan, an option that could save you money with added protection during and after the GM new vehicle limited warranty. For 36 months or 36,000 miles, whichever comes first, from $153 to $295. Look for this magazine ad or see your GM dealer.
It takes care of you as well as your car.
I don't like a flabby body, and I hate flabby hair. So, I got into Condition.
Condition Shampoo from Clairol. Protein enriched and formulated to restore healthy-looking body to damaged hair. Condition Shampoo revitalizes your hair's shine, gives it a clean, wholesome, healthy glow. Put an end to limp, lifeless, flabby hair with Condition Shampoo from Clairol.
Got flabby hair? Get into Condition.
Sunday.
Let the people go.
An incredible entertainment experience for the whole family.
Go out from among us, you and your people. Set you free.
Cecil B. DeMille's epic motion picture, The Ten Commandments, at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Favor, Granard, is...
Dean Wormer, sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, let's cut the enemy's marn here. Get on with it. What did your old man have to say?
He said that it wouldn't be prudent for a man in his position to climb aboard a sinking ship.
Ah. He said that, eh? Sinking ship? Well, that's it, Niedermeyer. I'm finished. If the rest of those guys on that board hate my guts, well, the hell with them. Faber College won't have Vernon Wormer to kick around anymore.
That's true. And if I may, I'd like to take this opportunity to say something of a personal nature.
What?
I'd like to add my name to that list of gut haters.
You?
Had a good long chat with Dad, you know. He pointed out to me that for 3 years I've been doing all your dirty work. He's right.
And all along, you led me to believe that it would pay off someday in power. Real power. The kind of power where you can push other people around. All wasted. 3 years of licking your boots when all along I could have been licking the boots of someone who could have gotten me somewhere.
Hey, Niedermeyer. You were the best.
Kent, my friend, there's a lesson to be learned in the misfortunes of Dean Wormer.
There is?
A woman can do strange things to a man.
She can?
And overwhelm, consume, and devour him. Eat him up and turn him inside out.
When, Otter, when?
It's all right, you want a beer?
No beer now, man. I'm almost done.
Well?
I'm done. Leading candidates to replace Dean Wormer. Hoover, we're in trouble.
Worse than Wormer?
I'll have that beer now.
Oh, boy. Let's see. Next, we have Dr. Benjamin P. O'Donnell, who is chairman of the School of Oceanography at the University of Oklahoma.
What are his chances?
Well, according to Swiney here, zip. Then there's Dr. Timothy Mitchell. Now, he used to teach medicine at Vassar Women's College.
Great.
He was fired for giving free chest x-rays in his apartment.
Not great.
Which leaves us, I'm sorry to say, with Dr. Carl Heinemann of SMI. Swiney says he's got it all sewed up.
SME University?
Southern Military Institute, Kent. And he's real bad.
Well, he couldn't be any worse than Wormer.
Among his innovations at Southern Military was the institution of solitary confinement for curfew violations.
I wouldn't mind solitary confinement.
If I could be with somebody.
That's not solitary confinement. That's getting lucky.
Listen to this. He abolished fraternities and has everyone living in, quote, undergraduate men's barracks, unquote. And he'll try to do the same thing here at Faber.
Quote, like hell he will, unquote. That, no question about it. We've got to help Wormer keep his job.
Yeah, but the Board of Trustees votes on Wormer the day after tomorrow.
Right, but this is today. We can still do something.
How, Otter, how?
Kent, there's one question a lawyer asks when he wants to save a client on trial.
What, Otter, what?
Who are the judges, and what can we get on them?
The hearing starts in an hour and we don't have anything.
Who would have thought trustees would be so pure? Look at this. He found some loose change in a coin return slot, and he left it there.
You know, I'll bet I could have gotten something on old man Niedermeyer if I only could have found him.
If the guys don't come up with something in this next batch, we're sunk.
My guys! Wait, you see what I got?
Boy, isn't this great, guys? Look what I got! Look! Here in the background of a photograph of one of the Board of Trustees, Mrs. Crandall.
She was returning a shopping cart that I hoped she was gonna steal, but no luck. But something in the background caught my eye, and I blew it up
bigger and bigger, and look! Mrs. Wormer and Buster Niedermeyer!
Yes! So that's where he was! You'll never believe what I got!
I got this picture of Mr. Trueblood eating soup in a restaurant, and something in a dark booth in the background caught my eye. I blew it up and... Ba-ho!
You'll never guess what I found.
We know!
Who and I have to tip the scales of justice. Come on, who?
Buster Niedermeyer!
Let me see your hand.
I would sum up my husband's moral character by saying he's a reptile, a creature completely without scruples. Friendship to him is just a means to achieve his own immoral, foul, and noxious ends. If I would offer any advice to this distinguished body, it would be to deal with my husband like a rat in the pantry.
Get rid of him.
This completes the witness's testimony in support of Dean Wormer. Now then, Dean Wormer, as this is a quasi-judicial proceeding, you may now call upon an attorney to sum up on your behalf. I'm sorry, we couldn't hear you, Dean Wormer.
Excuse me. But I'm afraid my attorney will not be able to come here and speak on my behalf. You see, my lawyer is too busy to come here and explain that I'm an honest, competent, fair-minded, calm, and personable dean of students. He can't come here because he's too busy working on my divorce. Too busy trying to keep a few of my hard-earned bucks from the grasping claws of this vulture.
What a poor excuse for a man you are.
Oh, I'll show you what kind of a man I am.
Face it, Vernon. It's over for you.
Please, Dean Wormer, you must show some self-restraint.
I'm sorry, sir. I must have lost my head.
It is now time to vote. As you know, unanimous vote is required in order to impeach a dean on the grounds of moral turpitude. You will mark your ballots yes if you wish Dean Wormer to remain, and no if you want him out on his ear. No. 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 I assume this dagger means no. No. One more and it's unanimous.
Finished. Finished. And alone. All alone.
Excuse me, your trusteeship. Eric Stratton and Robert Hoover.
Yes?
What are you guys doing here?
As a pre-law student and a recognized authority on Wormerology, I feel I'm...
Pre-law? I thought you were in pre-med.
That's right, he's pre-law. I can only offer this distinguished body my interest in the pursuit of truth, justice, and the American way.
Well, Dean Wormer.
Stratton and Hoover will bury me.
You're already buried. We're the only hope you've got, Wormy.
You may proceed. You have 2 minutes.
Thank you, sir. Just as you may not see eye to eye with Dean Wormer, my colleague and I have not always seen eye to eye with him either. But isn't not seeing eye to eye and having differences really what America's all about? I mean, where would we be without Republicans on one hand, Democrats on the other, rich people on one hand, poor people on the other, Martin on one hand, Lewis on the other? Surely you learned ladies and gentlemen must realize that when we eliminate a predator...
What?
Trust me, you upset the critical balance of nature. Why, without this man around, good people will multiply unchecked and deplete our natural resources.
Will you please get to the point?
Right. I submit to you that this man has not always been as you see him now. To refresh your memories, I have brought along several photographs of our illustrious dean carrying out the duties of his position, conferring with faculty, being kind to local children, giving classes in remedial reading. How many of the honorable trustees can claim such intimacies with the Faber community, such passionate involvement in the college's social life? How many? Do I hear an answer?
This is a mere formality, but having heard Mr. Stratton and Mr. Hoover, I must now ask any of you if you wish to change your vote.
My vote stands.
Mine too.
I don't wish to change mine.
My vote's all right as is.
Mr. Niedermeyer?
Yes. Yes, I'd like to change my vote. Please. I'd like to change it. Please.
Gentlemen, please come in. Make yourselves at home. And to what do I owe the pleasure of this visit?
Well, since you're still here, and since we were somewhat responsible for the fact that you kept your job,
we thought perhaps you might like to, thank us.
Thank you? I'd sooner eat rancid fish than thank you, you miserable subhuman larvae. And I give you my word, I shall continue to do everything in my power to eradicate once and for all the Delta plague from the body of this college. Thank you.
Cutlass watching has never been better, especially when it's your new Cutlass Supreme you're watching. One look will tell you why Olds Cutlass is America's best-selling midsize. And when you see the nice Cutlass Supreme price, you're looking at some kind of car.
There's a lot of news in Olds today. Have one built for you.
The paint on these walls is so washable, so scrubbable, it can take whatever the Harlem Globetrotters can dish out. Because it's Sherwin-Williams' most scrubbable latex wall paint, Classic 99. So it'll scrub up, clean up, stand up, just like latex enamel, scrubbing after scrubbing. Sherwin-Williams Classic 99, now on sale. Sold only at Sherwin-Williams. A paint, a store, a whole lot more.
Tomorrow, live from Las Vegas, Larry Holmes takes on Osvaldo Ocasio for the world heavyweight title. Saturday, superperson Paul Lynde takes off on today's big movies in a hilarious special, followed by The Love Boat. And on Fantasy Island, a young man's dream of being pursued by beautiful women turns into a nightmare. Now stay tuned for Family, next on ABC.
An ABC News brief brought to you by Ford Trucks. Now from New York, Bob Brown.
Good evening. Marine PFC Robert Garwood started the trip home today, more than 13 years after he disappeared in Vietnam. The Marine Corps has charged him with desertion and misbehavior as a prisoner of war. The Carter administration said today it will ask Congress to approve a $10 to $15 billion health plan to protect Americans from catastrophic illness. Senator Edward Kennedy said the Carter plan is too limited and he'll introduce his own soon. The White House has set next Monday for the signing of the Egyptian-Israeli peace treaty at 2 p.m. on the White House lawn. Now this.
Now your Ford dealer invites you to his open house. See this special edition Explorer and all the tough trucks from Ford. Come on in, now.
This summer, two dolphins carrying lights and cameras will search the deep waters of a lake in Scotland for the Loch Ness Monster. The dolphins are in training in Florida now. That's News Brief. More news later on this ABC station.
I'm John Vernon. If nothing else, the Deltas really show you what strength friendship has. Sunday night, ABC will show you another unique example, a child's look at growing up that people of all ages would love. Meet Pete, Nancy, and Randy, three special friends. Sunday at 7, 6 Central and Mountain.
Now, no bank or savings and loan pays a higher interest rate on 26-week money market certificates of $10,000 or more than National Bank of Detroit. Here's our new current interest rate. There are no fees or charges. And at maturity, we will automatically renew your certificate if you wish. NBD Money Market Certificates. Now there's no need to shop around because no bank or savings and loan pays a higher interest rate than NBD.
Call the inflation hotline at 298-6371. Call today.